it's our privilege to be here, guys. I won't do all the talking because it's them you want to hear from. But I'm Judy Clement, and I'm really privileged and proud to be the personal development manager for these guys. So I've worked for the Chiefs for 5 years, and I look after the boys' off-the-field interests and career after rugby. It's an amazing job to work with good young men, and I guess the reason why I'm so passionate about wanting to get behind this program is because I know the power of good young men, and I know the difference that they can make in the community. And if I can inspire and help some other men to do the same and be good young men like these guys are and dance like Robbie Fruin, then I'll be really, really happy. I just want to say a huge thank you to Paul for the invite. Paul, I didn't expect to be in tears within the first 5 minutes, but you had me there, mate. I've heard amazing things about him for the last few months in Hamilton. We work very closely with Craig Taylor, who's another police community cop in Enderley, and it's a privilege to work with Craig, and I can see it would be an absolute privilege to work with you too, Paul. So all the best, and congratulations on obviously the amazing work that you've done in this community. I think they're very, very lucky to have had you here. Woo! So without further ado, I'll introduce the boys that we've got up here. Unfortunately, none of them do come from the Waikato, unfortunately. but they'll explain where they do come from. So Tevita Kolomatangi, Robbie Fruin, Charlie Natai, and Tim Nono Williams, and I'll hand you over.
Mara Lili, my name's Tevita Kolomatangi, I'm from Tasman area, I'm from Nelson, down top of the south. Up here, this is my first year of the Chiefs, and So a real privilege to be a part of this program and to support it, and that's me. Thank you.
All right, how's it going, everyone? How's it going? Make sure we get everyone all together. So when I say mili, 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 all of you's got to rub your hands. So when I say patia, all got to clap your hands, okay? So warm it up, warm it up, warm it up. Ready, 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 ready. Mili, 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 patia, patia, no pati. Oh, two claps. When I say, oh, you got two claps, okay? Sit. Sweet. And when I say, toto fai, you gotta go this. Sweet. Okay, here we go. Mili, 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 mili. You get a little bit of a dance, a better dance than this, okay? Ready? Go this. Mili, mili, mili. Patia. Patia. Lua pati. Lua pati. Toto fai. Yeah, and that's me. This is all feeling new to me, and just from hearing what's been going on tonight, it's been massive, and I think it's a great concept. And I guess growing up, I grew up with four sisters, and I never really had a supportive network like what men's mates is. And I think it's a great concept, like I said before. And I think one of the biggest things is, I guess, in any man's life is trying to get over your pride and things like that. And so having to take that first step is always going to be the hardest. But I think once you take that first step, it's you realize the opportunity that you've taken up. And yeah, so it's a great concept. And honored to be here, so thank you.
Kia ora, everybody. Charlie Natai from Gisborne on the east coast, and just really support this cause. I know it's hard. I lost my dad young age and sort of had no one to look to, and I had all my mates and that, but I really look to my uncles in that, because they were my neck support network, and they were my fathers, so they sort of brought me up in that, and I see them all as my dad and that. But I guess if we can sort out our our things and that, I guess our young children will follow us and right behind us because they see us as our role models and that. And I guess that's me. I'll hand you off to Tim.
Cheers, Tony. Kia ora, everyone. Tim Nana Williams. Hey, I've been living down here in Hamilton for the last five years and played here for the Chiefs, so this is pretty much home for me. I'm a Jaffa, born Jaffa boy, but this is home for me, and I guess I got a little story, a bit of a life experience, and just a recent experience I had, and I had an opportunity to go to a place called Guam. I'm not sure if some of you know a place called Guam. I was the same as like you guys. I had no idea where this place was. I never heard of this place. And we got to work with police. Most of us were, all of us were rugby players. So there was one of each boys from New Zealand franchises. So from the Hurricanes, Crusaders and the Highlanders. And to be honest, I put my name forward because I wanted to go on a free trip. And some of the boys been on the trip beforehand, and I heard all the stories of, eating in your room and whatnot, getting free feeds and going to some fancy places. And I was lucky enough that I got picked and went over to Guam and worked with the police force, New Zealand police. And it was about domestic violence in Guam. It's a really bad, big issue with domestic violence over there. And going over there was a big eye-opener for me, I guess. Not just a free trip, but I guess it opened doors for me as well. I never really actually thought it would help me out, to be honest, because I grew up in a very violent home. Father was very, very, very violent towards my mother and my siblings. There was 8 of us. So I guess I'm not sure what was going through the old man's head, but I'm pretty sure he was depressed. Having all these kids running around, got to feed 8 mouths, and he resorted to, I guess, alcohol, and alcohol was probably the biggest thing that really affected him, and I guess that's why I really support this program. I jumped on this, and I think, as all the boys said, they're on board as well, and I guess just making our community a lot better, and not just our community, I guess this whole world. As you all know, domestic violence is actually a real big issue around the world. If some of you don't know that, every year we take a few boys to, I guess, to the Pacific Islands, and it's a real big issue. I guess it's because it's done the old way back in the islands, and I think for us going over there, big rugby boys, softies. Well, I'm pretty small compared to some of these rugby boys that they take over, and just telling them that, like what Rob said. Just throwing that pride away. If we throw that pride away and start talking, communicate, and I know most of us Pacific Island people don't really like to communicate because we're quite stubborn. And I found that through that trip, it really helped me as well. I'm a very stubborn person. I like to do things on my own. When someone tries to do something for me, I tell them to bugger off. And that's just men in general, to be honest. And you throw that pride away, and definitely doors will open up, and definitely this course and this program, it is going to really help New Zealand, but as I said, just not New Zealand. You never know, this program can go global as well, and the domestic violence program we've been on for the last couple of years has, I think they're going to Sri Lanka and Pakistan, and goes to show how far these things happen, and we're leading this in New Zealand. We're leading the world in this program, and I'm very grateful that I jumped on board on this. And to be really honest, it's took weight off my shoulders because it was the first time I've ever spoken about this in Guam, and it was on a radio station, so I never really thought it would be beneficial for me, but that's a bit of a story that and I guess what I went through when I was growing up, and I guess there's a light at the end of the tunnel, I say, but God bless, and cheers.
You'd have to agree, some very inspirational stories. In fact, I think they're all our official spokespeople for Mates. with after that performance. So once again, if anyone's got any quick questions from the floor, because I understand that the food is finally here and it's been worth waiting for, I can tell you. We've got one of the greatest caterers in the Waikato here tonight, called Stella Kitchen, and they've been very supportive of this event, as have Bidfest, the team at Bidfest. So very much grateful for their support. Has anyone got a question, quick question, for any one of the Chiefs or all of them at once?
All of them. Where are you going rugby-wise for the future? You going to bring home the cup this year?
We hope so. yeah, most definitely. The boys, we set a goal through the year and to win that third title, and that's the biggest goal for us, to get that third title. But I know it's quite hard to watch us for those Chiefs fans out there. A bit of a roller coaster ride, but bear with us. We're trying our best, and I know the boys. You know, we got three more games to go, and I think we need to win all three to make top six. So. Yeah, the boys are actually really ready. We got a thrashing today at training, so yeah.
Over there, just yeah, and they can definitely win all three, can't they?
Obviously, we work with men with domestic violence, and our look after our wahine and our tamariki. So we just want to say that we hope to get some networks and contacts out of this walkthrough tonight. So now, our guy who looks after our men in our programs, Te Whakaruru Hau, this is Jaxi, stand up, Jaxi.
You got told.
Thank you for that, and it's just, you know, like, I think one of the things that's been quite inspirational to all of us is the fact that, you know, so many women's groups as well have got right behind this program in terms of realising or recognising that it can actually start to change the whole process, okay? So at the end of the day, if you can prevent men from some of those issues that they face, then it's obviously going to have an impact on women as well. So that's, you know, that's one of the benefits. Quickly, last question from the floor, and probably from someone who's relatively youngish. Sue. normally I have those Hamilton boy twins to pick on. sorry, question, quick one, and then it's dinner.
Just a question for Tim. How did you overcome your dad being the way he was to take on rugby?
That's a good question, actually. I guess I had to make peace with him, to be honest. Because he's living in Brisbane right now. So I guess, you know, we had a few yarns when I started growing up, and I told him my side, and I had to really tell him. And I guess we all did as we grew up. We had to make peace with him, because if we didn't, then I guess I would have went down a different path, to be honest, and which I was kind of already. But I guess when I had that talk with him, then I asked him why, and he told me, and then, you know, it's not going to be all glamour with my old man, because, you know, just things don't really work out anymore. But I think that was it. I just really need to sit down and ask him why, and we had a good yarn, and then a few cries and whatnot, and you know, he said sorry, and you know, so yeah. And with rugby as well, like, yeah, I really took rugby because I needed to get away from that type of life, and my older brother played for the Blues as well, He sort of set the path for me, to be honest, and he became my father, to be honest, and sort of just followed in his footsteps. And I guess just like Charlie, he looked up to his uncles and they showed a better footpath, and that was the same for my brother. So I just followed in his ways, and I guess I'm very grateful and blessed to be where I am right now. Absolutely, without those people in my life, and I guess I turned to God as well. Without him as well, then I actually wouldn't be here, to be honest.
All right, now from one of the team are going to stay with us over dinner. Is that right? So we're going to have the chance.